In this video, we'll be looking at polygons, which are two-dimensional shapes. We'll be looking at their properties and how to find their internal and external angles. We'll then look to see how to use these facts in some example exam questions at the end. Before we start into the main concepts of this video, it'd be a good idea to make sure you understand the ideas behind the angle facts and foundations video, as a lot of the points from that one are referenced here. To start off with, we need to define what the word polygon means and how does it relate to shapes. A polygon is any two-dimensional shape that uses only straight lines for its sides. Another word that is used quite often with regards to polygons is the word regular. This means that all the sides and all the angles of a polygon are equal. This is a word to look out for, and we can use it to help us calculate many of the facts that we'll be using to solve these types of questions. Before we do that, let's look at the properties of some very common shapes. Here we have three different types of triangles. Let's run through the properties of each one. Firstly, here we have an isosceles triangle. In an isosceles triangle, two of the sides are equal, and that's designated by the two notation marks that are on the lines here. It's also true that the base angles of an isosceles triangle are equal. This isn't necessarily the angles that are on the bottom, it's the angle that these two lines point at. I always like to think of these two lines as arrows pointing at the two angles that are the same. To the right, we've got an equilateral triangle. With triangles, we've got a specific name for this type of polygon, but it could also be called a regular triangle. In the angle facts video, I said that a triangle has got the internal angles of 180. That is to say, you add up all the angles and you get the sum of 180 degrees. In an equilateral triangle, all the sides and the angles are the same. So we can divide 180 by 3 to get each of the internal angles, which would be 60. The fact that all triangles have the internal angles of 180 is an important fact, and we'll come back to that later on. It helps us calculate the angles for all polygons. The next triangle we have is one that most people assume is a right angle triangle. But unless we're shown that there's a right angle, we can only state that it's called a scalene triangle. In a scalene triangle, you have three sides, none of which are the same size, and you have three angles, none of which are the same angles. One triangle that you may feel is missing from this range is a right angle triangle. However, we can add that as a further categorization of both the scalene and the isosceles triangle, as a right angle triangle can be classified as either of these. It's important to watch out for each of these types of right angle triangles and ensure you don't assume that it's one or the other, especially when calculating their angles. Here we have the range of six named quadrilaterals. A quadrilateral is a four-sided shape. The first one in the top left is a rectangle. We've already noted that the opposite sides are the same length by putting the notation marks on the lines. We've also noted that the angles are each 90 degrees. We can also state the opposite lines are both parallel, and we put the arrows on like this. The next one we have, just underneath it, is called a square. Again, the opposite lines are the same length, and in this one also, each of the angles is 90 degrees. This is the regular quadrilateral. We use it so often that we have a special name for it, which is a square. And we can do 360 degrees divided by 4 to get 90. We'll show you how we got the 360 degrees in just a moment. In the top right, we've got something that looks like a squashed rectangle. This is called a parallelogram. Again, the opposite sides are the same length, and also the opposite sides are parallel. Another property of a parallelogram is that the opposite angles are the same size. Now, if we look at a parallelogram, we'll find the two angles on the left-hand side will add up to 180, and the two angles on the right-hand side will add up to 180. This looks very similar to our co-interior rule from our parallel lines. Underneath that, we've got what's called a rhombus. This looks like a square that's been squished. The opposite sides of a rhombus are the same length, and in fact, all four sides of a rhombus are the same length. The opposite angles are the same, and again, the angles on the left-hand side add up to 180, and the angles on the right-hand side add up to 180. The next one we've got here Now you'll notice the only property that it has is parallel lines. It's called a trapezium, and that's the only thing it needs in order to be classified as a trapezium. There's no special thing about the angles, it's just that two of the sides are parallel. And lastly, we've got this one. You can notice it's got two sides that are the same length and another two sides that are the same length. You can also say that one of the properties of this shape is that each of these angles that are opposite are the same size, and you'll probably recognise this as being called a kite. One of the things with a kite is that you can draw a line of symmetry straight through the length of the kite. And if you drew another line from one of the side angles to the other, you'd create an angle in the centre that's 90 degrees. It's well worth knowing that for when we come to it later on, because it often comes up in order to calculate the angles in a kite. The reason for running through all of the properties of triangles and quadrilaterals is that very often you can use them as reasons for answering geometry questions on polygons. Now, we'll see how to calculate the internal angles of any sided shape, given that you know the number of sides. Here, we've got a range of regular polygons. Remember, the word regular means that the sides and all the angles of the polygon are equal. Throughout this exercise, we'll work out the sum of the interior angles for each polygon, whether it's regular or not. Then in the next exercise, we'll look to find a single interior angle for each of the regular polygons. This will end up giving us a formula to use for all future polygons questions. These always tend to be quite high value questions in exam papers that many students either leave or can make simple mistakes on. The way to calculate the internal angles of a polygon is to think about the minimum number of triangles that can be used to create it. As you can imagine, the minimum number of triangles used to create a triangle would be one. As each triangle has the internal angles that add up to 180 degrees, that is the internal angles of a triangle. Whilst this may sound simplistic, we can now use that logic to calculate all the other polygons' internal angles. As you can see, the minimum number of triangles for a quadrilateral is two. So we can calculate that the internal angles by saying two triangles, so two times 180, which equals 360. And we can go through and do this for all of the shapes. By defining how many triangles is the minimum amount to make up a shape, we can calculate the interior angles for each polygon. So next we've got a pentagon, and we can see we can split that into a minimum of three triangles, which would give us 540 degrees. Four triangles would make up a hexagon. Five triangles would make up a heptagon. An octagon would be six triangles and would give us 1,080 degrees. And a decagon, which is 10 sides, would take eight triangles and would be 1,440 degrees. So having completed all of those, we can create the formula for the internal angles for each shape. I've gone through and written in all the numbers of the sides and the numbers of the triangles and the sum of the internal angles for each of these shapes. In the last row, we can review the relationship between these two facts to create a formula. If we use n for the number of sides, and the number of triangles in each polygon was two less than the number of sides, then the formula for calculating the internal angles of any polygon, irregular or regular, will be n minus 2, and then times by 180. If we now look at refining this for regular shapes, we can calculate each internal angle in the same way as we did with an equilateral triangle, by dividing the sum of the internal angles by the number of sides. We can go through and do that for each of these shapes. The formula at the bottom is that we can say the value of the internal angle is n minus 2 times 180 divided by n. Now, from angle facts, you'll know that the angles on a straight line equal 180 degrees, and an internal angle and an external angle create a straight line. So if we take the internal angle and subtract it from 180, we'll get the external angle of a regular polygon. At this stage, you might be able to guess what the external angles all add up to, but if not, multiply the external angle for each regular polygon by the number of sides. This now gives us two ways to work out the interior angles of a regular shape, either through calculating all the internal angles and dividing it by the number of sides, or by subtracting the exterior angle from 180. Let's look at how we can apply these rules on some exam questions. In this question, we've got two regular polygons, ABCDE and EHJKL. And we have an equilateral triangle, EAL. There's the word regular to describe the pentagon. And we know that this also applies to the triangle as well. Let's see how we can apply the formula we've constructed in this question. So we need to use the formula to find the internal angles of a pentagon, unless you've memorized it. It's going to be n minus 2 in brackets times 180 and then divided by the number of sides, or n. So for the pentagon, it's going to be 5, take away 2, which gives us 3, times 180 and then divided by 5. So that's 3 times 180 divided by 5, which is 540 divided by 5, which gives us an internal angle of a regular pentagon being 108. And we can write that on the diagram here. Next, the triangle. We know it's 60, but let's just run through the formula. 3 take away 2 gives us 1 times 180 divided by 3, and that'll give us 60. And again, we can write that on the diagram. Now, from the angle facts video, we can remember that the angles around a point equals 360. So we can do 108 plus 108 plus 60, which gives us 276, and then we can subtract that from 360 to get the remaining angle, which is DEH. So if we subtract that from 360, we get 84. So we can say that angle DEH is 84 degrees. In the next question, we're told that the interior angle of a regular polygon is 11 times the size of the exterior one. We can find the exterior angle by dividing 360 by the number of sides. Let's see how we can use that piece of information to solve this question. You can pause the video now to calculate the answer yourself and press play when you'd like me to calculate the answer. So here we've got the word regular for our polygon. So we know that we can use that in order to calculate the answer. We know the interior and exterior angles add up to 180. So we could write the diagram like this. We could draw a straight line and then the angle. And we can say the exterior angle is X. The interior angle must be 11 times that, or 11x. And we know that 11x plus x will equal 180, because they're angles on a straight line. We can then combine those like terms to get 12x equals 180, and then we can divide both sides by 12 to get x equals 15. Now we have that knowledge that the exterior angle equals 360 divided by the number of sides. Well, here we know that the exterior angle is 15 degrees. So 15 degrees equals 360 divided by the number of sides. So if I now multiply both by the number of sides and then divide by 15, I can swap those two around and end up with the number of sides equaling 360 divided by 15, which calculates to be 24. So we can say this polygon has 24 sides to it. Through this video, we looked at how to calculate the internal and external angles of polygons. We used a formula to construct the amount of triangles in a polygon, and we found that the external angles will always add up to 360. And we could use that to determine the interior and exterior angles of regular polygons. In the next video, we'll be looking at measurement and conversion using the metric system. I'll see you then.